You'll often see in mainstream media and on social media in the UK that there's a lot of anti-EV stories, and you'll often see it reported that electric vehicles create more emissions because they're heavier and they create more brake particle matter and emissions from tyre wear. So it's a complete load of rubbish, of course. Electric vehicles aren't any heavier or much heavier than their combustion engine counterparts. And the truth is that all modern vehicles have got much heavier, and they don't wear tyres out any quicker. And certainly when it comes to brakes, there is a huge, huge difference. So the press would have you believe you're wearing out these brake pads much quicker in an EV than you would in a combustion engine vehicle, which is a load of rubbish. An automatic combustion engine vehicle wears out the pads and the discs much, much quicker. So with an electric vehicle, you're doing the majority of your slowing down using the electric motor. That's the regen braking effect, and that's basically engine braking in an electric vehicle. So the motor is slowing you down rather than using your friction brakes. And here's a good example. This is a Hyundai Ioniq Electric. It is now 3 years old and has done 40,000 miles. And you're not going to see this on camera really, but there is absolutely no lip there on the brake disc, showing that there's virtually no wear. I can't, well, maybe 0.2 of a millimetre, 0.1 of a millimetre, hardly anything. And these are the brake pads at 40,000 miles, and they are at 11 millimetres. So they've worn about 1 millimetre in 40,000 miles. If this was an automatic combustion engine vehicle, these would probably be worn out now and would need changing. So the reality is, in this vehicle, these pads will probably last 150,000 miles or more, and the discs will probably last the life of the vehicle. But of course, it does depend how it's been driven, of course. And that's good for the environment, of course, because brake dust is horrible stuff. We don't want to be breathing this stuff in, and of course, it's also getting into the waterways as well. But with most electric vehicles, while these brake pads can last 100, 150, maybe even 200,000 miles or more, it's usually corrosion, which means they are replaced before the actual friction material is worn out. The backing plates can often start rusting and swelling, which means they get a bit sticky, and you can get scoring and things in your discs just because of lack of use. So it's usually corrosion, which means these get replaced rather than actual wearing out of the friction pads. So servicing the brakes on an EV is still vitally important, just cleaning them up, lubricating it all, just to make sure these move freely, and then you will get an incredible life out of your pads and discs. So I hope you found that useful. If you have, as always, please do click the thumbs up, that really does help. And if you want to know more about the Hyundai Ioniq Electric, I'll put a link to a playlist in the video description where you can see other videos on these vehicles.